The Arctic natives have always been closely connected to nature. Fishing and hunting has been their livelihood for thousands of years, but their traditional way of life is now being threatened, and it may no longer be safe for them to rely on nature as their primary source of food. Recent studies have shown levels of toxic mercury in the Arctic wildlife that are high above natural levels, and the mercury levels are rising at a disturbing rate. Mercury and most of its compounds are extremely toxic, and after centuries of use by man, mercury is now distributed all around the world. It's concentrated in the Arctic food chains, leaving its marks on both humans and animals.
Today, the concentration have increased more than 20 times relative to the baseline level. This means that more than 95% of the mercury that polar bears are carrying is of man-made origin.
When we look at the polar bears and the seals and even the local people, they have some of the highest levels of mercury on the planet. But it's somewhat paradoxical because there is no source of mercury here. It's coming from far, far away.
Mercury occurs naturally on this planet. But pollution by this toxic chemical has risen due to human activities such as mining and burning of coal. Today, mercury is causing a significant disturbance in the world's biological systems, threatening humans and animals. Each year, more than 2,000 tons of mercury is emitted into the global environment by man's activities, and significant amounts of this mercury are transported by wind and ocean currents to the Arctic region.
What we have seen is that emissions from both east and west ends up in the Arctic. Due to climate change, that results in more mercury ending up in the Arctic. As ice is melting, permafrost is thawing, and rivers and rain patterns are changing, more of the trapped mercury is released into the environment. All of these effects on the physical environment will change the mercury cycle and release more mercury.
Mercury released by human activities has been steadily rising since the beginning of the Industrial Revolution 200 years ago. However, recent increase in mercury pollution has been accelerating due to the burning of coal, especially in Southeast Asia, and also due to its use in small-scale gold mining. Mercury has become the preferred tool for washing gold for poor miners in their quest for the golden material. The method is simple, but dangerous to the miners and to the world.
Small-scale miners, gold miners all over the world, they use mercury to extract gold. And the mercury which is in the tailings gradually is washed out. And then it enters the streams, and the metallic mercury is gradually transformed to what we call methylated mercury or organic mercury. And it is transformed by bacteria, and it goes into the food chain. And the top of the food chain is first the big fish and then us.
In addition to causing local pollution of some local fish resources, this mercury is now transported around the world by ocean currents. But these activities only account for 10 to 20% of the total man-made mercury emissions. It's the burning of coal that causes the major problem.
When coal is burned, mercury trapped in the coal is easily released into the air. Mercury, now in its steam form, can remain airborne for months. And due to processes caused by the sun and forming ice, mercury is released faster from the Arctic atmosphere than anywhere else on Earth.
Airborne mercury and mercury washed into the oceans are the two major distribution channels for the mercury across our planet, now leaving the Arctic in danger.
And we've seen time and time again that animals and humans that are exposed to high levels of mercury suffer from neurological damage, and it's of concern here in the Arctic.
The latest Arctic mercury assessment by AMAP shows that in some parts of the Arctic, as many as 90% of women of childbearing age have blood mercury levels above the recommended level, and this could increase as climate change alters mercury pathways.
Small amount of mercury can affect the brain of unborn children. Metalmercury is transported by the umbilical cord from the mother's blood to the child, where it has an impact on the developing brain.
Children may exhibit learning disabilities, lack of language skills, and loss of concentration. In some Arctic areas, pregnant women can no longer permit themselves to depend on traditional marine foods, forcing them to turn to other local resources and imported products.
But in other societies outside the Arctic, people are also becoming exposed to mercury as well. People eating contaminated tuna fish can be as highly exposed as people in the Arctic. This will not stay as an isolated Arctic problem.
Arctic mercury pollution and its effect on Arctic populations serve as a warning for the rest of the world. As global fish consumption increases, other communities relying on contaminated marine resources may, in the future, suffer the same effects we are witnessing today in the Arctic. Now, mercury is also found in some local rice stocks, something that was thought to be impossible only a few years ago. The latest research tells us that the problems could continue to worsen if we do not adopt existing technological solutions.
By putting an end to the pollution, we are not only solving the problems here in the Arctic, we are at the same time reducing the threat to human health for present and future generations all over the world.
Мигу титтинеруна нигитсарнеарнекаалуарту илекану пиллугу норсоомегати пасигати икутта татаннагуна карсиннаа